Hey guys, welcome to Intriguing Tech. This is a slightly different video to what I normally do. It's not a review video, it's more of a repair video. Here I have an nVidia Shield 2017 controller, and basically stopped charging, and I believe the battery inside it is dead. How do I know this? Well, basically here I have a power bank and we have a USB display. So if I turn it on, you normally see 5.5, there's 0 amps, and basically when I plug it in, it should show amps going into the controller, but it's not. It shows a voltage. There, it showed 0.4 amps, but it won't take it in. Now, it stopped charging. Okay, so what I'm going to do is put this battery into the controller, and this is what the battery is. As you can see, 1800 milliamp hours. And the part number is NSP920SL. That's the manufacturer. And I'm going to use a TORX 6 bit and possibly some mobile phone prying tools. I don't know if I'll need them or not, but I have them just in case. What you have to do is use a TORX 6 screwdriver bit here and remove these 6 screws. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I've got my pry tool in and I'm going to insert it into the crevices. There we go, simple. Seems to be coming undone pretty easily with the right tool. That was fairly simple. And we're open. Right, since it's a part, there's the old battery pack, and you should be able to just disconnect it from here by pulling it like that, and now we have the part disconnected. Time to get access to the old battery pack. There's the old one. Don't know if you can see the writing, it's really small. And if your button pops out like this, it's just here, goes in. Right, I'll just slip the button back in. I do it from the top. I have this prying tool. Basically the battery is glued in here, so you can just try and yank it out slowly. And it comes undone. I'll save that. Hi, it's me, M from the future. So I took apart the old battery pack off camera and it appears to have a thermistor connected as a safety device to prevent the battery overheating while it's charging. So if you attempt to make your own battery pack, be sure to add a thermistor. Right. Before, as you put the new battery in, there's a little notch here, if you can see. It goes in to the corresponding little notch here, if the camera will focus. Just push it in. And I can already tell it's working because my shield has come on. Right, I've put it back together. It's fairly easy, just be careful of these buttons here. They tend to pop out and this top triggers. Now time to put the screws back on. Okay, well, everything's back together. Now to give it a quick test to see if it charges up. I have my power bank here, showing 0 amps being consumed and 5 volts coming out. And let's plug it in. It's in and 5 volts and 0.4 amps consumed. So there we are. The battery is taking charge and it works because I can see the shield is on over there in the corner. Okay, thanks for watching this slightly different video. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll leave a link in the description for where I bought this battery. Okay, cheers.